Department of Computer Engineering at Gokhale Education Societies are at Support College of Engineering Management Studies and Research Nasik is committed for value embedded quality technical education along with holistic personality development. The department has 120 intake for bachelor's degree and 12 intake for master's degree. The strong pillars of our department are well-equipped laboratories with high-end computing facilities, Wi-Fi enabled campus which cater the need of today's computing era. The department has a blend of young, dynamic and experienced faculty members who constantly put their effort to adapt to technological changes by enhancing their skills. In addition to the core academics, the department also focuses on co-curricular activities such as a spectrum of seminars, workshops, quiz contest, code hackathon, project competitions. The department is awarded with CUDA Teaching Center from NVIDIA, various grants from AICT, SPPU and Zensar Training Center. The department has continuous growth records in placement. Since last few years, our students are placed in many IT companies such as TCS, Infosys, Wipro, Zensar, KPIT and also local giants such as Vinjit, Netwin, Illuminus, Eris, ESDS and so on. We always attempt to give our best to impart knowledge to our students to make them good engineers who will serve the society.
Yes, good morning to everyone.
Yes, sir. Good morning to all. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Okay. A warm welcome to all of you. Santosh Kumar, sir, is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. We can directly start with the session.
Yes, yes. My slide is visible, ma'am.
Yes, yes, sir. Just make it full screen.
Yes, yes. So today's our topic is data clustering and visualization. So today we have to learn what kind of data clusterings are there and what kind of visualization are to data on various, how the data will be clustered, how the data will be grouped together, and what methods and what technique to be used. Because science, in the data science field, whenever you have to do the analysis of raw data, our ultimate agenda or objective is you have get some value, get some information, or get some result. So visualization is a great tool, or to it is a graphical representation of our data, how the nature of data, which type of distributions are there, whether that distribution is normal distribution, whether that is distribution different kind, data is similar and 10%, and kind of relation between different features of the data set. So let me clear that in the data set having the various kind of features, 10 features, 100 features, or we can talking about the more than 1000 features are available in nowadays. You can take the example of marketing data. There are so many features are there: location of customers, salary of customer, address of customer, designation of customer, age of customer, in which group age has purchased this particular mobile phones. That is our questions. There are bundle of questions are there. So what kind of relations are there? Is there any relation between age and designation? Is between occupations, whether this is a, they are working on the salaried person, non-salaried, self-employed, professionals, like that. There are so many verticals are there. In short, we are talking about features are there. So out of these, we have to find out best solutions according to our problems. So first of all, what kind of data cluster is there? What is a data clustering? And why it is usage. So clustering is an unsupervised machine learning method of identifying and grouping similar data points in a larger data set. In a larger data sets without concern of a specific outcome. Here we don't have knowledge about the labels in which group. Clustering and classification, there are two different segments are there. In the classifications, we are knowledge about, we have to classify this particular data in this particular group or this particular segments. But unsupervised, we don't have knowledge about where you have to segregate. In the unsupervised, just we have to prepare a group of similar nature or behavior of a data points. In data science, after that you have to prepare clusters, so to go for analysis of cluster. Clustering is the task of grouping a set of objects in such a way that objects in the same group called a cluster are more similar in some another sense to each other than to those in other groups. So there are different clusters we have to create it. Here, just suppose here in the one bucket, there are three different colors balls are there. We don't have knowledge about white ball, white, red and green. White ball we have to group together, red we have to group together, and green we have to group together like that. We don't have having about the in the our classifications, suppose 0 1 0.5 0.2 0.3. If your value is greater than 0.5, segregate this set. It means you have know the value or know the results. Here we don't have knowledge about the group objectives. So here there are so many algorithms are powerful technique for machine learning on unsupervised data. In that, the main task of exploratory data mining and a common technique for statistical data analysis used in many fields, including machine learning, pattern recognition, image analysis, information retrieval, and bioinformatics. You can imagine that here I have to write for another segment that is known as bioinformatics. So here our biostatistical is separate statistical analytical tools are required for processing of bioinformatics data. Cluster analysis itself is not one specific algorithm, but the general task to be solved. Whatever cluster analysis or cluster techniques are available, itself it is not one specific algorithm. Nobody can make a challenge that if you have to apply this particular clustering algorithm and you will get the result. There is no specifications are there in that algorithm, but the general task to be solved. But the general task here you have to apply whether this raw data, suppose we are having the customers data, in that data which algorithm will be suitable, whether K-means is suitable, hierarchical cluster is suitable, DBSK-N clustering is suitable, or Gaussian mixture model is suitable, how you are going to get the correct accuracy of that particular result, because it is totally based on behavior of data. So whenever we have to perform the clustering analysis, our first step is understanding of the data. Without understanding of data, we cannot select the algorithms, because there is no specific algorithms are available which will be solve your problems, because algorithm selection is totally based on nature of your data. It may be a structured data, it may be unstructured data, it may be semi-structured. Suppose we are having the unstructured data, in that case it's very difficult. I hope that everybody got these things. So now we are talking about the some applications. Anybody guess that what kind of applications of real world application of clustering? Anybody, do you have any idea? Do you have any idea? Am I audible?
Yes sir, you are audible.
Yes sir, you are audible.
Yes.
But just make your screen full.
Yes.
Maximize it.
So here we have to list out some real world application of clustering. These are the some verticals where we have to apply clustering algorithm and get the solutions. Grouping of hierarchies of products, recommendation engine, biological classification, typologies, crime analysis, medical imaging, market research, social network analysis, Markov chain Monte Carlo methods. There are so many different, if you are talking about n number of applications are there, in that problem we have to solve with the help of clustering techniques. You can take the recommendation engine. In nowadays we are talking about the e-commerce site. Suppose you have to click on some of the products, suppose mobile phones. If you have selected this particular phones, and immediately they have to suggest that these are so many phones are also available for in your budget or in your specification or in your requirement. So you can also view these features specification. Suppose if you have to make the filters, in that filter you have to provide, we want a smartphone, the range between price between 10,000 to 20,000. There are so many variety they have to recommend. So that is the task of recommendation engines. Recommendation engine will be select this particular information and represent in front of your screen. Same in crime analysis, which type of crime is there, how many growths are there in this particular, and why, when, where, all these questions will get the answer of these things. Same thing in medical imaging, you have to take the ECG, digital image, and that here you have to find out healthy images and some infected images. After that comparison, that have to find out some issues, research, market research is there, which trends are going on. So your best example, customers are purchasing, which type of customer segments are in which city that customer will be available, in which city that customer will be available. In social network analysis, there are so many, there are every day so many images have been posted by the people, and there are number of videos are shared by the people, which type of effect to the society, which are not viable, which are some different categories. which are not allowed this particular social media. You can talking about the some of the report, some of the account has been blocked for the 24 hour, 48 hour like that. These things are only possible because here we don't know the end result. You know the only raw data. There are so many text posts are available. So in that, which posts are not useful for the society, not good for the society. So there are so many applications there. So just we have to go through the how you're going to select this algorithm. Now, question is, clustering, when you should use it and when you have to avoid it. You know the clustering. What is the role of clustering and supervised machine learning algorithms? Clustering. So when you have to apply the clustering methods or clustering techniques, and when we have to avoid these things. In that, no matter what type of research you are doing or what your machine learning ML algorithms, there is no any criteria or issues are there. What type of research you are doing, whether you are doing the pattern recognition, whether you are doing in the bioinformatic research, whether you are doing in the some network analysis, whether you are doing some the recommendation engine, some different, it may be the variety of questions are there, problems are exist in the society or in the real world, and what kind of machine learning algorithms. Because machine learning algorithm, there are so many algorithms are available. Ultimate aim is we need to go for the accuracy of your model. Suppose your accuracy of in the case of medical field 99.99% accuracy is there, then your algorithm is suitable. Otherwise, go for the tuning the model, again tune the model, learn the model, train the model, do the exercise, repeat this process. Clustering and data preparation go in hand. Data preparation is one kind of step or stages for development of data science life cycle. First part is understanding. After understanding of data, we need to go for the data preparation. In the data preparation, what kind of activity for data scientist or data analyst? First of all, they have to identify how many missing values are there. What kind of distribution of this particular data? Whether this is a normal distribution, what is the density of data, and whether this is the some outliers are there. If missing values are there, again replace it. If the data is in the character format or some character format is there, need to convert in the numerical format, because until and unless you have to convert the data, without conversion of data in the numerical format, we can't go for the calculations. So here there are go for the one term is known as, that is known as feature engineering. There are so many algorithms are there, hot encoding methods are there, level and level is there. Then you have to data is you have to transform in the hot encoding technique, apply the hot encoding technique and perform the map the features. Suppose red is one, green is two, three, four, five, like that, some variety of how many features in this particular column. How many different deviations are there? What kind of relation from the feature one and feature two? One-to-one relation is there, one-to-many relation is there. All those things you have to understanding in the data preparation, and you have to remove. And now the after prepare the data, now your data is useful for train the or distribution of the test and train data. So here, clustering and data preparation go hand in hand, as many times you will be working at least initially with data set that are largely unstructured and unclassified data. If your data is structured, there are very simple tasks for the data preparation. But nowadays, everywhere data is generated, almost data is unstructured data. Cluster analysis can help you segment your customers, classify your data better, and generally structure your data sets, but it would not do much more if you do not give your data a broader context. Our example is marketers can perform a cluster analysis to quickly segment customer demographics. What kind of customer segment demographic? Quickly segment customer demographics. Suppose understood whether this customer is capable to buy the product or not, because they have business history there, which kind of similar product they have to purchase. Quickly drill down on risk factor and locations and generate an initial risk profile for applicants. Here our best example is in the risk management teams are there in every bank. Yeah, they are asked about the, you have to send your PAN card and Aadhaar number, and easily they have to identify whether how much credit scores are there. So in that credit score, they have to analyze how much score you have to gain it. After gaining that score, they can easily identify whether how much risk for this particular customers, whether he is eligible or not. So initially risk profile they have to generate, and after generation of initial risk profile, that manager or authority will be easily conclude that whether he or she is capable to get the loan of such amount. My credit score is very low, so I am a very risky person. Are there, if our credit score is very high, then easily able to get it. So here insurer can really drill down on risk factor and locations, in which location how many risky persons are there, and generate an initial profile and applicant. It may be the location based, it may be the city based, it may be the age group. There are so many criteria will be there. On the basis of that, they can easily get it. So that is the part of only cluster analysis. They have to perform the age group of clusters. If the age of 25 to 45, they are the very prominent proficient person to repay their loan. If your age is 60 to 70, you are, because after 60 to 70, you are the retired person. So you are not capable, you don't have the capability to pay off more than such amount like that. So these things are only because of only possibility, because of only the cluster analysis. And these data are unstructured data, because if I'm talking about the locations, cities, area, in which sector you have to working, all these are the questions. Now, clustering is an essentially a set of such cluster usually containing all objects in the data. Here this is a one kind of clusters. Additionally, it may specify the relationship of the cluster to each other. If you have to prepare number of clusters, so what kind of relation for cluster 1 to 2, cluster 1 to 3, cluster 3 to 4, like that. So we must have knowledge about, you must may specify without a specification of relationship of the cluster to each other. It's very difficult. So for an example, hierarchy of the cluster embedded in each other. This is a main cluster, inside the sub clusters are there. So clustering can be hard clustering and soft clustering. Hard clustering, each object belongs to a cluster or not. Each and every data point which are available in a data set, whether each object belongs to a cluster or not. Suppose we are having the 50 objects. Out of 50 objects, your 48 objects are belong to the clusters, and remaining 2 objects are not a part of cluster 1 and cluster 2. Suppose we are having the data set, in that our total records is 50. Here we have to perform the clusters, in that we have to prepare 2 clusters. So cluster 1, cluster 2, total population of cluster 1 and 2, 1 and 2, 48. What about remaining 2? Because our total object is 50, so out of 50, 48 objects are part of the cluster, and two are not a part of either cluster A, 1 or 2. So here this is known as each object or node, that is known as each object belongs to the each cluster to a certain degree. Example, likelihood of belonging to the clusters. So there are distinguished cluster, distinguished hard clustering and soft clustering. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, no issue.
Yes, yes. Now we are talking about types of clustering algorithm. How many different kind of clustering algorithm, how you are going to classify. So every methodology follows a different set of rules according to their rules for defining the similarity among the data points. Whenever we have to prepare the clusters, so for that they have to set the rules. So for set of rules for defining the similarity among the data points, whatever your groupings are there, all objects are similar in this particular group. So in the case of machine learning or in the case of data science, because data science totally uses the machine learning, so whenever I have to use the machine learning, this is the synonyms of the data science you can talking about. The in the machine learning, classify algorithms on the model's behavior. Whenever you have to develop their models according to their behavior, so here whether your model is connectivity, whether your model is centroid, whether your model is distributions, whether your model is density based, or here we have to add, because these four different features they have to supported in the R programming, graph and graph based models, group and group graph based models, these are supported in the Python. Remaining all six are supported in the Python. So in the R programming, whatever the library package are available, in that case they have to classify their clustering algorithm in four different models. One is connectivity, another is centroid, third one is distribution model, and fourth one is density models. So here, as far as model is concerned, what kind of relations are there? If you have to go through this particular nomenclature of models, these are totally behavior or attribute of the models, and easily we have to find out what kind of relations of the data point in this particular model. In the centroid, according to the centroid, they have to develop their clusters. Distribution, what kind of data distributions are there, what kind of density of this particular data points are there. It may be the images, it may be the numerical value, it may be the text, it may be the documents, group models, and graph based. Now we have to go through the one by one very quick. In the connectivity models, these models are based on the notion that data points closer in data space exhibit more similarity to each other. So what about the data space? So this is known as our data space. If you have to observe in this diagram, so here each cluster, suppose blue color cluster indicate that, so here connectivity is there, data points are closer in the data space. In the blue cluster there is no red spots are there, or there is no blue spots are there. This model will be start with the classifying all data points into separate clusters. Here we can see that blue color data points are separate cluster, red color data points are separate cluster, and some another color, purple is there, yellows are there, some are the outlier, they are not a part of this cluster as well as this cluster. So here start with the classifying all the data points into separate cluster and then aggregating them as a distance decreases, and all data points, our second term is all data points are classified as a single cluster, then partition as a distance increase. This distance is different. This is a single cluster, this is a single cluster, and then they have to identify the distances. This red spot is not a part of this particular cluster. So the choice of distance function is subjective. And example of in the connectivity models, which kind of clustering algorithms comes under this particular categories? Radical clustering algorithm and its variants. So here they are focusing on the into separate the cluster and then aggregate them. All data points are classified as a single cluster, then partition as a distance increases, and third conditions are the choice of distance function is subjective. Next one is centroid. Everybody, this is the well-known clustering models are there. Everybody know this particular example. I hope that if anybody knowing about the cluster, so everyone know about the k-means. It is iterative cluster algorithm in which the notion of similarity is derived by the closeness of a data point to the centroid of the clusters. K-means clustering algorithm is a popular algorithm that falls into this category, the number of clusters required. Our here one more essential parameter is there. Whenever you have to develop the k-means cluster, so we have to pass the parameter in our programming, how many number of clusters you want to create, whether you have to create 4, 3, 5, 6, n, and these models run iteratively to find out the local optima. So here they have to find out the closeness of data point with respect to the centroid of the clusters. Here this is centroid of this particular cluster, this is centroid of this particular cluster, this is a black cluster, this is a centroid of this particular cluster, and according to this centroid they have to find out the distance of their data points. They cannot find out the distance of this particular data centroid. For this cluster, they have to find out whether this is a part of this cluster or not, how much center to the data points are there. And this is a iterative. Again, it is a very popular algorithm. Everyone know about the, if I'm talking about the clustering, everybody knowing about the K means I know the clustering. Now, so these clustering models are based on how probability is it that all data point in the cluster belong to the same distribution. So here they have to find out the probability by what kind of probability to find out or to find out this particular data point belongs to this particular clusters. If in this particular figure, if you have two new data cluster assignment, here you have to observe that plus cluster 1 circle, or you can say 0, is cluster 2 fitted GM contour. Here they have to plotting the contour map. So here they have to find out plus is a separate cluster and circle are a separate cluster. These models often suffer from overfitting. I hope that everybody knowing about the overfitting and underfitting. Overfitting means your training model will be produce the high accuracy whenever you have to test or whenever you have to supply some another data. At that time it will produce the very less accuracy. It's not a fit for, it is not a proper train of your model. Underfitting, it is less learned to your model. So these models often suffer from overfitting. Overfitting is a major problem in the machine learning because each and every time your model will not produce the correct result. Here a popular example of this model is the expected maximization algorithm, which uses multivariate normal distributions. Generally they have to use it in the mapping or contour mapping like that, or plotting or labeling some of the particular area or regions. Now density model. So best example of density model, here our popular example, first of all we are talking about the example because DBSK and optics, very popular examples. Density models are DBSK and optics are there. These models search the data space for area of where of data point in the data spaces. We have to observe that there are some different clusters are there, populations are there, these are the different clusters are there. Here there are the 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and according to your density of data points they have to prepare their clusters. It isolate various different density regions and assign the data points within these in the same cluster. It isolate various different different density regions and assign the data points within these regions in the same cluster. Popular example of density models are DBSKnet. Just you have to go through the one by one here. K means already you have to. The algorithm is composed on the following step: place K points into the space represented by the objects that are being clustered. These points represent initial groups and droid. Assign each object to the group that has the closed set of your centroid. You can talking about there are three different clusters are there. One is red color, another is blue color is there, and some green color dot edge is there. So here this centroid is different. Centroid of this particular red color cluster is different, and green color cluster centroid of green color cluster is different. When all objects have been assigned, recalculated the positions of the K centroid, repeat step 2 and 3 until the centroids no longer move. The K-means algorithm does not necessarily find the most optimal configuration corresponding to the global objective function minimum. The algorithm is also significantly sensitive to the initial random selected cluster centers. So here, major challenges is initial randomly selected cluster centers. So this is a sensitive issues are. It is one kind of simplest unsupervised learning algorithm that has to be solved well-known clustering problems. Here we are talking about some different things that is known as scree plot. What is the use of this one? I hope that everybody knowing about these things. If you don't know that, then here our we are going to here this concept is used for analysis of cluster. If you have to apply now, it's very simple. People can prepare their clusters. Whether that is good, here you have to provide number of clusters. Suppose you have to prepare four number of cluster, k equal to four. Four number is sufficient, cluster number is sufficient. If you have to prepare six, if you have to develop six instead of six, we have to develop 16. If you have to increase the number of cluster, so our complexity will be increased. So here a scree plot is a graphical display of the variance of, this is very important things are there, display of the variance of each cluster component. Because here I am talking about the variance, this is statistics word is there. So a scree plot is a graphical display of the variance of each component, each means cluster component, each component which is used to determine how many components should be retained in order to a high percentage of the variation in the data. What kind of variations are there? What kind of variations are there? Whatever your resultant line is there, resultant graph is there, in that how much error, how much dispersed data value from your average value, how much distance, how much, whether it may be the negative, whether it may be the positive value, how much distance from the average value, average value to actual value, determine how many clusters should be retained in order to explain a high percentage of the variation in the data. The variance of each component is calculated. How you're going to calculate the variance? That is again one concepts are there. So here the variance of each component means each cluster is calculated using the lambda of I, summation lambda of I into summation equal to 1n into lambda of I. So where lambda of I is the ith eigenvalue, ith eigenvalue, and summation of I equal to 1 into n into lambda of I is the sum of all of the eigenvalue. Lambda of I is the eigenvalue of ith cluster component, and summation of I will be start from 1 to n. So 1 to n, so I will be start from 1 to n. So here sum of all of the eigenvalues. So lambda of I into summation of I equal to 1 into n into lambda of I. By using this particular formula, here we calculate the variance. So in the variance of that, here you have to find out the relationship between cluster components to determine how many components should be retained in order to explain a high percentage of the variation in the data. Our third point is the plot. Now here this is a eigenvalues, and here x-axis represent the component number, so 0 to 13 in this graph, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, up to n. Eigenvalue 0, 2, 4 in the range of 2, 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, like that. The plot shows the variance of the first component, and then for the subsequent component, first component, in the first component, eigenvalue is 10. Component, eigenvalue is suddenly 50% goes down. Third component number is here 2. Fourth component goes to the 1.5 or 1, you can say that less than 1, less than 2. After that, this is goes for the saturated line, a steady line. So this plot shows the variance for the first component, and then for the subsequent component, it shows the additional variance that each component is adding. Because first cluster created there, there is various fluctuation is high. Whenever second, third cluster, fourth cluster, then this variation will be stability. So there, this is a high percentage of the variation. This is a high percentage of variation, and here our variation is a stability. So that is known as a scree plot. This is one kind of mechanism or methodology by which we have to find out the variance between component. Variance of the clusters. Now, how it look like? A scree plot is sometimes referred to as an elbow plot. We can observe that this is a hand. This is a x-axis, and here suddenly y-axis is there. Here again, it is similar to our plot to this one. Component numbers are there, and here eigenvalues are there. So here, in order to identify the optimal number of clusters, what will be the optimal number of clusters for further analysis, we need to look for the band in the graph at the elbow, where you have to see band of the elbow. This is indicate the optimal number. So here of cluster should be 3 or 4, because here slightly variations are there. What kind of bands are there? Elbow is there. So here it is similar to this one. In this location, either you can consider this one or this one. So that will return to a back to a reverse back to a reverse back to a bend in the graph at the elbow. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, yes, you're audible, sir.
Yes, yes. Now, another mechanism is Solo 2 refers to a method of interpretation, interpret and validation of cluster. First of the plot, we have to identify what kind of number of clusters are optimal, whether 4, 6, whatever numbers. Because if optimal number, then go for, as we have been talking about, 30 is the good, 15 are good. If you have to use this particular plot, in that plot, you have to at least you should know the idea of if you have this much number of cluster is a or this much, at least you should know the range, close range. This is the plot is referred to interpret and validation of clusters of data. Now you know the optimal number of clusters. Now how you're going to validate, interpret what kind of information you have to gain from this particular clusters, that information is valid or invalid. So here, interpretation and validation of cluster of the data, this technique provide a sequent graphical representation of how well each object lies within, how each object lies with and was described by Peter J. Rosum in 1986. So you have to observe that 2, 3, 4. Cluster C2 N2 have how much values are there? 20, 15, 17, 23. SOFI indicate average cyclotic width 0.072, 0.8, 0.68, 0.75. Average value is width is 0.74. Here, plot of x equal to kilometer, clusters, distance equal to d, like that. So this is a graphical representation. This method refers interpretation and of data. Inside data, whether that data is correctly belongs to this particular cluster or not, whether they have to conditions or not, if they have to part of this particular cluster, so what kind of contribution they have to generate, what kind of answers, what kind of problem or what kind of answers they have to generate, what kind of information they have to produce, like that. So that is known as interpretation and validations of the clusters. So there are two different methods are there. One is find out the optimal number of cluster. So the cyclotic plot is to identify the point of highest average cyclotic width, that is in short ASW. So here average cyclotic width is here of the 0.50, 0.60, 0.650, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Here cluster equal to 4. So whatever your peak values are there. So in this graph, our peak value are 0.70. So this is known as, this is the optimal number of cluster for analysis. So this is a optimal number of cluster. So here component number is 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So previously we have to got the some close range, and here you have to know the exact range. What kind of average ASW, average cyclotic width, that will be the peak value, and here you have to plot of the component number, that is known as 4. So it will produce, with the help of these information, we have to find out the optimal number of cluster for the analysis. I hope that everybody got these things. So cyclotic plot is used for find out the optimal and interpretation and validations. Here, plot shows the spread of data within each of the generated clusters. A principal component and greater than two dimensions can be utilized to view the clusterings. This principal component analysis is used for the reduction of the dimensions. What kind of dimensions? You should reduce unwanted features which are not a part of calculation, that calculation will be directly affected to our accuracy of the models. Some of the features are only available in our data set. They are no directly affected to our accuracy. So that dimension or that features we have to reduce, and then you have to sort it with of dimension of the data used for the calculations. That is the part of principal component analysis. So here we are talking about greater dimensioning, but means that at least two features, two to three. If there only two features are there, what kind of reduction you have to provide? So here principal component analysis can be utilized to view the clusterings are there. So here my data, different data are there. These are the there, but these plots are developed on Ruspini data set. Ruspini data sets are available in the R programming. Here we have to show the example. Here is an example of k-means clustering based on the data. Here cluster equal to 4. If we have to observe that cluster equal to 4, these are the, they have to belong to the cluster. Here go for the cluster plot. Here you have to find out the relations. You can observe each and every, there are different cluster, these are the different cluster, these are the different cluster. What kind of relations are there? What will be the maximum number of clusters, are optimal number of clusters are required for, and each data point should be part of this one. And here our circle is, circle is there, plus is there, again plus is there, triangles are there. This cluster, what kind of interpretation is there? What is the validation values are, ASW values are there? Here again, this is 4 plus, this is 3 plus, this is a 1 plus, this is a 2 plus. So this is a cluster, second cluster, third cluster, and fourth clusters are there. So if you have to use a scree plot or cyclotic plotted, in that you have to find out the optimal number of clusters, all data points, and whatever data points are available in the particular clusters, whatever data points are available in this particular cluster, what kind of information they have to generate it, what kind of information they have to produce. That is the part of clustering analysis. Now our second methodology or hierarchical clustering. Hierarchical clustering output as a hierarchy, a structure that is more informative than the unstructured data set of clusters returned by flat clustering. So here dendrogram with AU values are there. This kind of, what kind of relations are, this cluster is different, the relation of this is a subcluster of this one, then this is again subcluster of this one. So here 94 90 78 79, this is the ASW values are there. Distance correlation clustered method average class, again this is elaborated, again classify this one, again inside two clusters are there. So here easily we have to find out hierarchy of the clusters. Hierarchical clustering does not require us to pre-specify the number of clusters, and most hierarchical algorithms that have been used in IR deterministic. These advantages of hierarchical clustering come at the cost of lower efficiency. Here our hierarchical clustering is cost of, its very efficiency is very less, computation is high. Again we have to know the relations. data set is same. Here again, cluster is 4. So here, this cluster group 1, 2, this cluster is different, dendrogram is plotting. Again, 4 clusters are there, green, blue, red, and black spots are there. So here is an example of hierarchical clustering based on the same Ruspini data is there, and then dendrogram is plot, number of cluster is 4, all values are accommodate. Now, here we are talking about, this is very useful method or very complex problem. Every complex problem they have to solve Gaussian mix model. Here our normal distributions are there and Gaussian distributions are there. It is known as, we can use for clustering, involves the application of the EM algorithm for Gaussian mix models. The approach uses the M-clust package in R that utilize the BIC statistics as the measurement criteria. The goal for identifying the number of cluster is to maximize the BIC. How many number of maximum number of cluster had been generated? Not talking about the minimum number of cluster. This approach is considered to be a fuzzy clustering methods. Either 0 or 1, whether this is a part of cluster or this is not a part of cluster. Here we are talking about, you are talking about the boundary spots are there. Green values are all data points are accommodated in this particular clusters. Here, this is a border points are there. Again, this is a border points are there. You cannot identify that single data point is part of both the clusters. We cannot identify single data point is a member of both the data clusters. Either they have to part of this particular cluster or they have to part of the some another clusters. It's not possible intersection of both the clusters. Single data point cannot be a part of two different clusters. Single data point, identical or individual data points, member of a single data point, single clusters. Not to the single data points, to the two different clusters like that. So here, just we have to see how the graph will be look like. Again, here are some diagnostics which are useful to establish the correct fit to the data. The maximum BIC indicate then a cluster equal to 5 should be used. Here our raw data are there, scatter plots are there. In that scatter plot, we are plotting the clusters. So here number of component either 2, 4, 6 or 8. If you have to observe that, if you have to prepare the two clusters, so here variation will be look like. You have to observe. This is different, this is different, this is. If you have to prepare number of cluster is 4, here our all are the same in the same point. EI, BVI, VII, EEE, EEI, EEV, EVI, and VVV. So here 2, 4, 6, 8. So if you have to go for the 6, again some variation. All lines are different. Different locality, this is up, this is down, this is overlapping. Again, this is overlapping to this one. Here, this is a down. Whenever you have to increase the number of clusters, that goes to the up. Again, goes to the up. And here, the line is up directions. And after that, if you have to increase the number of clusters, it will goes to the down, again go increase the numbers, goes to the down, again increase the number of clusters, again goes to the down. So this kind of variation, fluctuations are there. But we have to observe in the number of 4, all are the perfect relations are there. Variation, there is less amount of variations are there. So that is the part of Gaussian mix model. Here number of BIC and here number of components. So here BIC is in the case of a number of cluster is number of component. So here the maximum BIC indicate that cluster 5. So here near to this one, cluster 5 above the 4. Again, M cluster, mixed model in the clustering. The M cluster is a package in the R programming. The M cluster classification chart depicts that five centroid distribution and also the relative degree of the classification uncertainty. Here classification uncertainty. So here this is a different spot, this is a different, this is a different centroid, this is centroid is different, but our data is outside. Again, this data is far away from our centroid. This data is far away from the centroid. This data is far away from the centroid. Again, this data is away from the centroid. This is inside, but this is away from the centroid. Again, this is inside this one, but this data is away from the centroid. So here, cluster classification chart depicts the five centroid distribution and also the relative degree of the classification uncertainty. Classification uncertainty. So these are the various kind of clustering algorithms. Clustering algorithms. Now, here we have to go for some practical clustering technique, cluster technique. Now, here our problem is there. This is the image. For that, we have to perform some operations, whatever you want. And the goal of clustering exercise should be to identify appropriate pockets or group of the data and that group together. So here, need to some processing, need to identify some object. Suppose we have to identify the object eye, nose, mouth, like that. So here our first task is, whenever we have to perform and whenever we have to develop some use cases for the clustering or any classification, our very first task is understanding the data. The goal of a clustering exercise should be to identify the appropriate pockets or groups of data that should be grouped together. So here we want to prepare the cluster of nose, eyes, two different eyes. So we are very clear about the, we have the four groups, one for the single eye, this eye, another is for the this eye, and then go for third nose, and fourth one is the mouth. So our identify the appropriate pocket or group. So here we have four pocket group of the data that should be grouped together, because the structure of underlying data is usually unknown. In this image, we don't know about the structure of the data. So there could be many different clusters created by different clustering techniques. Suppose you have to apply the k-means, some different cluster will be generated. If you have to apply the hierarchical cluster, they have to generate some clusters. If you have to use the Gaussian, some different cluster they have to generate. DBSK, some different. So therefore, let's use a data set where it's obvious what the number of clusters should be. What the cluster should be. How we are going to find out the correct number of clusters? Let's use a data set where it is obvious the correct number of clusters. So for that, a scree plot and symplectic plotting is there. So in that, you have to find out the interpretation and validations. So for that understanding of data, now we have to observe here our pocket or groups are very clear. This is the eye, this is a eye cluster, this is a nose cluster, and this is cluster. This data set clearly shows that there should be a four clusters, two eyes, one nose, and one mouth. Four clusters, two individual for the eyes, one for the nose, and one for the mouth. So here, cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 3, and cluster 4. Mouse data points are interpret. You have to identify number of clusters. There are 4 clusters. So here our cplot optimal values are 4. Without knowing particular values, it's very difficult. It's very difficult to get the value. If you have to apply some different cluster technique, you may get some different number of clusters. You also get the some eyebrow, one cluster separate for the eyebrow, another cluster for the eyebrow, one cluster for the separate hair, like that. So there are so many possibilities are there. Now, k-means, if you have done, let's first run a k-means clustering algorithm. Here k equal to 6 clusters. The k-means produce too many clusters based off of the data sets. So here our scplot is eigenvalue. Here eigenvalue is 100, 200, 300, 400, like that. Component number 5, 10. So here 6. Let's check it. So here this cluster is different. This cluster is different. This cluster is, there are 3 different cluster. This is cluster different. This cluster is, both are the eye. One is a nose. And mouse, they have to divide it in 3 different clusters. One for the left side, another is a right side, and one is a center. You can observe it. Here our elbow, value of elbow or band is 5, or clearly we can say that this is band value. So here our band value is 6. So this is known as analysis. How many number of clusters are required like that? In the hierarchical, now let's use the hierarchical clustering method. K equal to 4. K equal to, again, 4 clusters are there. Here, cluster components. Siloti plot is, so here, maximum value, peak value. Here, average siloti width, AWS, is 0.5. So here, width, siloti plot width is 5, like that. So now let's use the hierarchical clustering method, K equal to 4 clusters. So that is a maximum number is 4. This peak value is, below the 5. So now let's use the hierarchical clustering methods, K equal to 4 clusters. So this is a peak value of this particular information, that is 4. So that is a optimal number of clusters. So here 4 clusters are there. So this is a 4 cluster is one eye, left eye, right eye, nose, and single cluster for the mouth. In previous example, we are talking about the 3 different cluster for mouth. I hope that this, if you have any questions, you can ask me. Do you have any questions? You can ask me.
Participants, any question? Please ask the question.
Yes.
Okay, still we are having the 10 minutes. So if you don't have the questions, then we have to go for the some demonstration. We are having the some examples.
Yes, sir, please.
Yes. Okay, this is my screen. So here we have to talking about the some k-means clustering. So here you have to take the data set. There is about the terminal. Here we have to editor. This is the editor. In that you have to write your code. Very simple codes are there. 1, 2, 3, and then here we have to take the input as a data. Whose mini data set is available inside the packages of data. These are the predefined. So we need to read these things are there. So here head, they have to information of these things. So here we have to run step by step. First step, set. Here we have to set dot seed one means currently. Then data, here some warning, they have to Ruspini not found like that, but actually data is available here. Here we have to head. Head indicate that some few informations, some upper information they have to plot it here. So there are two features. One is X, another is Y. Value of X is 4, value of Y is 53, value of X is 5, Y is 63, 10, 59, 9, 77, 13, 49, 13, 69, like that. So these are the feature of X, feature of the Ruspini data set is feature of X, feature of Y. Plotting the head, at least you should know the basic information of your data set. Then here you have to Ruspini equal to here. This is one kind of variable. In that variable, you have to passing the dimensions. 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. So here, after that, you have to plot the density. Here you have to plot. Plot means a scatter plot. Whatever your values are there, so this is our data. X-axis indicate the, you can observe the x-axis value range from 0 to 13, they have to show, but 0 to 120, y-axis indicate the 0 to 150. According to that, they have to segregate or scatter the plot is there. After that, here you have to apply the k-means clustering algorithm. After running curve, here they have to clustering in different colors. This is a blue, red, green, and orange colors are there. Again, you should know the information of KM is one kind of variable that they have to display the cluster analysis. So these are the cluster analysis. So here cluster vector is there. Within the cluster, sum of a square by the cluster, that is known as 1456.655, 4558, 3689. And 3176.783. There are four different clusters are there. So four different, this is a cluster one. What will be the sum of the square? Second cluster sum of a square 4558.23, 3689.50, 3176.783. And available components, clusters, centers, dots, witness, dot, dot, witnesses, between SS, ITR, it fault. These are the available component of the data set. So this is one kind of, this is a cluster analysis. Here cluster mean also we have to cluster, four cluster means are there. X, X-axis 68.93, Y-axis 19.4, cluster 2, 98.178.167, 114. Y-axis 114.8824. These are the summary of clustering with four clusters of size 50, 17, 20, and 23. These are the size of cluster. There are different kind. 15 values are there, 17 values are there, 68, 19, cluster means are. So you can observe that how many values are there, 50 here, 17 value cluster size, and 23 values are there. So these are the summary of clusters. All informations, what is the mean, how many number of size, how many components are there, what is the summations, and what kind of components are available in the clusters. Now Hierarchical cluster, just loading the things. Okay, successfully MD5 check completed. DPLIR package are installed. Install all packages. Every is working. Okay, head empty car is a data set. In that, these are the features: MPG, cylinder, displacement, HP, drag, weight, VS, AM, gear, car blinded. All these are the information of our data set. Then calculate the distance matrix. These are the distance matrix. Hierarchical cluster. Distance name, average, Euclidean, number of object 32. Here, cluster dendrogram, we have to plot it. Here we have to observe. Cluster dendrogram. हाँ सर, यस सर, यस सर, 5 मिनट में खत्म होगा, 1 ही मिनट आएगा सर। सो ओके, सो दिस इज द प्लॉटिंग द डेंडोग्राम, देन नाउ दिस इज द टेबल फिट, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वैल्यूज आर देयर नाउ यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व दैट ग्रुपिंग things. Distance matching H cluster underscore effort. So these are the all about the clustering. You can start programming wireless or you can also use the Python, no issue. So we have to stop there. If you have to question, you can ask me. Otherwise, we have to stop here. Sir, shall I stop?
Yes, sir. If participants have any questions, they can ask.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. It's really an informative session and it will definitely enhance our knowledge. Now I request to Manlik, sir, to give vote of thanks to our speaker.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank Professor Santosh Kumar of SRM IST Ghaziabad for taking time from his busy schedule to share his valuable guidance in data clustering and visualization with real life examples, explanation of k-means algorithm, centroid models, distribution models, density models, along with plots and a lively demonstration in our studio. It gave us deep insights into topic and also revealed some interesting facts of data clustering and visualization. Thank you very much, sir. And special thanks to all our participants for taking time out from their busy schedule to attend this FDP. We look forward to welcome you all again tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. Thank you all. Over to you, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you all. And the quiz will be shared on WhatsApp group only. So see you tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone. So much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for your informative session.
Thank you.